friends, this is the lecture number 14. Today we are just talking about the heap. Before coming in this lecture, you must go in the lecture number 13. In lecture number 13, we have already discussed on the tree, subtree, strict binary tree, full tree, and forest, and complete binary tree, and binary tree, about the level, height, children, nodes, and leaf, depth, and edge. Okay, all the topics we have covered in lecture number 13. So in this lecture, we are just talking about the heap. What is heap? Heap is a complete binary tree. What is the definition of complete binary tree? That is the definition of heap. If you write, that is enough to get full marks. Okay. So what is complete binary tree? After that, there is a question that what is complete binary tree? Complete binary tree, if you have a tree and if all the leaf nodes have height either h or h minus 1. You know that if its height is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and its height is 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Suppose you have this strict binary tree, okay. You have a strict binary tree. This is a strict binary tree, okay. So you can see that this leaf has 1, 2, 3, 4. Its height is 4. Its height is 3. Its height is 2. Its height is 1. So every leaf has different heights. But the condition, according to the definition of complete binary tree, your height must be h or h minus 1. Means either it must be 4 or 3. But here 2 and 1, so this is not complete binary tree. So the definition of complete binary tree is the height must be h or h minus 1 and there must be a sequence. Means this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So there is no miss element in your nodes. 2, 3, 4, 5. So all the elements are coming as a sequence, okay. So means if you will put this data here, okay, in this condition it will not complete binary tree, okay. This data it will come here and here you have lost, there is no subtree. In this condition it will not subtree, complete binary tree, because there is no sequence. Now here heap means heap is a complete binary tree, okay. So now this is the definition, and there are two types of heap. You will write that there are two types of heap. Number first is the minimum heap and second is the maximum heap. What is the definition of minimum heap and what is the definition of maximum heap? Minimum heap means at first you will complete the maximum heap. Maximum heap means if father is greater than children, then this is the max heap. Means if the data, this is the father, this is the children, 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 okay. So if the father has more data than children, then this condition say that this is the definition of maximum heap, okay. That is the rules of maximum heap. Now you can see that 36 is greater than 32 and 29. 32 and 29 are the children and 36 is the father and it has more data. Now 29 is the father and these are the children. 20 and 28 are less than 29. Okay. Now this also 32, that is less than, sorry, this is greater than 17 and 22, and also 17, this is greater than 16 and 14, and 22, it is also greater than 15. So all conditions also satisfying. According to the definition of complete binary tree, the height must be, its height is 1, 2, 3. Its height is 3, and this leaf, its height is 2. Okay, if height is h, the complete binary tree height is either h or h minus 1. This is the definition of complete binary tree. And also the sequence, the node, it must be like in a studio, there should be no mismatching. My suggestion, go in the previous lecture number 13 to just understand the complete binary tree. The first one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All the nodes are coming, okay, from left to right. If you will put this data here, then this will be never complete binary tree. The data must be shifted from left to right. Okay. So if you have written like this, then this is a complete binary tree. Now, what minimum heap? What is minimum heap? Now, minimum heap means every time your father, it will be less than children. Means children has more data than father. Then this is the minimum heap. Now, you can see that 20... less than equal to, okay, this is also less than equal to, okay. If you can see that father it is less than equal to children, father is less than equal to children. So children has more data. Okay, children has more data. 20 is greater than 20 is equal to 20 and 20 is less than 27. So children has more data. Now 20 is less than 36 and 20 is less than 39. So children has more data than father. So this this condition inside the minimum heap. Okay, this is the definition of minimum heap. The definition of minimum heap means the children must have greater data than father. Okay, so now and also you can see that according to the definition of complete binary tree, its height is equal to 1 plus 2. Its height is 2 and its height is 1. The leaf must have height either h or h minus 1. This is the definition of complete binary tree. So it is also following the condition of the heap. Okay, and this is also complete binary tree because according to the sequence you will put this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there is no mismatching. Means you have to write all the data from left to right. If I will put this two node here and I will remove this one, then this in this condition it will never complete binary tree. Okay, this is the definition of complete binary tree. The data must be from you have to write from left to right. Okay, there must be a sequence. That is the definition of complete binary tree. Now I will give you some example. It has come in your GATE exam. Okay, I am writing something here. Okay, so this is a very important, this has come in your GATE. A heap with no nodes always has order of log n height. Okay, this is the very important. Now this is the question. Okay, so there are this is a tree. You can see that this is the complete binary tree. Okay, and also here we have not written the data. Okay, so here we are checking that it is working or not. So now here you can see that the height, what is height? 1, 2, 3, 4. According to the definition of height, the total number of edges from root to the deepest leaf, okay, is called the height. Okay, it is the definition of height. Okay, so the height, it is total number of this is equal to total number of nodes. How many nodes are here? Now after that I will talk that how many nodes are here. The nodes are, total number of nodes are here 2 to the power n. So 2 to the power h, sorry, 2 to the power h. Okay, so 2 to the power height is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 16. Okay, now you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So total number of nodes are 16. Okay. Now total number of nodes are 16 here. Now we will use this formula. Now log base 2, okay, 16, because total number of nodes are 16, I am just taking it. Okay, then this is equal to we can write log 2 base 2, 2 to the power 4, 2 to the 4 to the 16, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. So it is coming 4, that is the height. You can see that. So what we have written, a heap with no nodes always has order of log n height. So its total height is order of log n. Its total depend on number of nodes. You have to count the number of nodes, you have to write it, and after then it will show us the height. That is the height. We have already counted total number of height is 4. Okay, so how many nodes? At first you will count how many nodes are here. You will put the data here. Put the data here, then it will give us the total number of height. Okay, so in the exams they have given you this graph and he asked if there are total number of 100 nodes, then what is the height of your heap. He has asked this question. So you have to put the 100 here and you have to take the base 10, then after then your answer, it will be you will get your answer. Okay, so now now the second question for binary heap. Okay, what is the time complexity to insert or delete? What is the time complexity to insert and delete for this heap? What is the time complexity for to insert the elements in your heap, binary heap, and what is the time complexity to delete any nodes from your this binary heap. So you must also, this is also very important, many times it has come same also, okay, this is also same thing, to find how much height, same thing also you have to write here log n, okay, both are same, this is very very simple, okay, this question it has come, okay, this question also it has come in your exam, so you must learn it, this is very simple, already I am just telling you that there are many, okay, that for binary tree, for binary tree the insertion and deletion all time it will be order of log n, after some time we will discuss. In binary tree the insertion and deletion time complexity is all time order of log n, okay. So thank you so much.